Lydia, well played. This was becoming quite a regular thing, you talking to me after another match-winning innings.
Yeah, no, it's just I'm really pleased that we've got off to a good start and 1-0 going into the rest of the games. And I think we've still got areas that we need to improve on, which is good, and looking forward to Melbourne.
Talk us through the chase, chasing 141. You know, what were the thoughts as you guys sort of went out to bat?
We've always spoken about keeping up with the rate and not really worrying so much about wickets, and that's what Charlotte and Laura did at the beginning there. I think we got 13 off the first over, so straight away we were up with the rate, and I think that's just what we tried to do all the way through.
You mentioned it was quite a positive start, wasn't it, by Charlotte and obviously Laura and obviously Danny White as well. Then you came in at 50 off for three. You know, what was your thinking there when you were batting with Susie?
Yeah, again, just to be positive. Lainey, our coach, spoke to me about maybe guiding us through there, but I thought obviously we were still chasing seven and eight, so I had to be as positive as I could be, and Susie did a really great job coming in there and hitting a big six as well. So no, it was really good that all the girls coming in knew exactly what they were doing, and yeah, it's just a great win today.
It was your partnership with her of 47 which pretty much set up that victory. What did you think of Susie's performance?
I think she did really well. She did really well out in Sri Lanka, and she showed what she could do against the Aussies here as well. Yeah, she's just a very strong girl and can hit the ball a long way, and obviously in 2020 that's a good thing.
So you both sort of matched each other with a big six each. Unfortunately she fell, and then there was a sort of two more wickets that fell as well. Any nerves from your point of view when you were six down?
Yeah, a little bit. I think at one point the run rate went up to eight, and we just said we're just going to keep being positive, and I think we sneaked a few fours there in the field, which was good, and then after a couple of overs we found ourselves at sevens and sixes again. So I think from there we just wanted to milk it and make sure we get one a ball, which is what we did.
Seems as if the running between the wickets was really important as well.
Yeah, definitely. I think we've spoken about if it goes either side to a fielder, generally you can make it in, and if it's a direct hit, then you're going to be pretty unlucky.
In many ways, it actually seemed like quite a comfortable victory. 10 balls to spare. Did it feel that comfortable?
No, it didn't. No, not at all. I think, we were just happy to win it. Obviously, with 10 balls to spare in a 2020 match, you could say it was quite comfortable. But I think all the way through, you never really know what way it's going to go.
So first blood to England in the first of five 2020 matches, now onto the MCG. What another fantastic occasion that proved, you know, that should be.
Yeah, definitely. Before the men's game again, so obviously a really good opportunity for us to show what we can do. But I think the Australians are going to come back at us much harder. They're a very good team, and I don't think they'd be happy that they lost that first game. So it's good that we're 1-0 up, but we know that we need to keep on improving.
Obviously, the Australians are the World 2020 champions, which is a crown which obviously you girls held after that fine victory at Lords in 2009. Do you still feel as if you've got something to prove, obviously, after that disappointing World Cup in the Caribbean last year?
Yeah, definitely. I've said before that a few of us are scarred by that, obviously not even making the semi-final. So, I mean, as a group of players, we just want to keep on improving and get ourselves back up there. And obviously, with a win today, that's a really good start for us.
And I guess, obviously, sounds like a silly question, but, you know, you're obviously going to be dead keen to actually win this series and win it, you know, win it well.
Yeah, definitely. I think four games to go, it'll be nice to perform well again in Melbourne. But like I said, we know the Aussies are going to come at us really hard, so we've just got to be ready for them and make sure we put in another good performance.
Congratulations, well played.
Thanks for asking.